Dear viewers, in this video, we are going to look at how to draw a mind map using FreeMind software and how to include text effects, how to include graphical element, how to apply text cloud, how to use graphical links, and how to include table and table attributes and many more features. Keep watching. Open the FreeMind software, this butterfly icon with FreeMind name, double click. It will launch the software, maximize it. Move to root, maximize it and go to the menu name navigate, move to root to bring this root node in the center of the page. Double click. This is the software I'm going to discuss about education technologies. So education technologies, ready. Next. It won't allow to use again. For example, let me maximize format larger font, format larger font, apply larger font, or you can use control equals. So it will be keep on increasing education technology. If you notice, technologies shown as here. Error, mistake, grammar mistake. So why it shows is we are not allowed to use capital letter in the second word. If you want to use capital letter, just ignore, you keep moving on. So now the root node is ready. Next, right click, new child node. The very first topic I'm including about Google Classroom. Here also spelling is right. The problem is it does not allow to use capital letter in the second word onwards, only for the first word it allows. If you want to include next software, education technologies, just double enter, then it will come. Yet Puzzle is the next software. Next, we are going to discuss about FreeMind. Yes, now if you want to use this end, this entirely focused on the right end, now we are moving on to the left end, new child node. Here we are discussing about assessment tools. Just to include second node, double enter, you click. Next, Ruby star, rubrics design. Otherwise, just keep it here and use right click, then new child node for child of rubrics. Right now, the focus is towards the node named as rubrics design. And new child node, rubrics design, the software used is Ruby star. Suppose Ruby star, you want to explain what are all the features. New child node, Ruby star has a feature for scientific drawing, rubrics for scientific drawing. It has numerous, more than 50 features. Let us include 3 to 5 features. Again, go back, see, we were in the focus. We were keeping the focus on scientific drawing, move to Ruby star, right click, new child node. Now the second is scientific presentation. Next, Ruby star, new child node. It allows for team presentation rubrics. It allows to customize. Again, it allows to customize rubrics for mini project. It allows to customize rubrics for oral presentation, etc. Now, all the features of Ruby Star have been included. Under the education technology, one of the software is Rubrics Design. Within that Rubrics Design, the software used is Ruby Star. Ruby Star has these are all the features. Now let us come back. Google Classroom. Google Classroom has a lot of features. What are all the features? Right click, new child node. To include new child node, Google Classroom has the features for post creation and again go back or keep it in the post. Then new sibling. Previous, just above the name called post, if you want to create something, then you have to use new previous sibling. If you want to create a sibling below to the post option, then you have to use new sibling node. Then within this, we have the option for assignment. Now, before the assignment, if you want to do, then previous sibling. Above the assignment, it does now. Announcement. Google Classroom, again, it allows to use new child node. For the assignment, we can use forms, Google Forms. Again, for the announcement also, child node, it allows Google Forms. Over. Now, we want to decorate this Google Forms with the icons. Now, since we are using only the text, it permits us to use text as much as possible. Within the assessment tool, we want to use new child node. One of the assessment tool is Mentimeter. Another assessment tool, new child node, you can use or go to the Mentimeter, use it, new sibling. Then it comes below. Now, another software for assessment is Kahoot, Mentimeter. Now I want to create above, so new previous, then clickers. So these are all there. Anytime, any node, you have to keep here free mind. Just free mind, right click, new child node. Free mind allows text effects. Again, it has numerous features. So free mind allows new child node, graphics. Again, above graphics I want to include. Then graphics, new previous sibling. It allows tables. Next, below the graphics I want to do. New sibling. Then below it comes. Then it allows tables, graphics and text cloud. Enough. Now, what to do? Education technology, we have increased the font size. Now, the remaining font size are very smaller. Let us increase Google Classroom format, larger font, or use format, control plus equals the key combination. Control plus plus plus, increase the size. Now, get puzzle, control plus plus plus, increase the size. Free mind, control plus plus. Assessment tools, control plus plus plus. And rubrics design, control plus plus. Ruby Star, control plus plus. Whichever the node you would like to increase the size of the node, font size of the node, then you have to use control plus plus. Now post, so control plus plus. Next, clickers, control plus plus. Mentimeter, just use arrow. It becomes very easy. Just use arrow for the navigation or mouse for click option. Control plus plus. Now throughout the font size is increased. Now announcement, control plus plus, control plus plus. Font size, if you want to increase, keep increasing. Plus plus. Just use the arrow key. It will help you to navigate up and down side also. Now almost we have increased the size of the font for each and every node. Now let us move on to the next option, how to include icons and how to include other text effects. So now text education technology, go to the format, then use node color. Node color is for changing, now I am applying this color. Now it is to change the color of the font. Now assessment tools, format, node color, use a node color to change the color of the font. Now I am choosing maroon color or red color. Now Ruby Star font, use node color. Now I'm going to use blue color. Now blue, Ruby Star is in the blue color format. It, the visibility will not be exciting. So let us change it to purple color. Now Ruby Star is purple color. Google Classroom format, node color, move to some other colors which is more visible. Yet puzzle, then you go for applying node color. Now 4-5 times the demonstration is over. Hope that you would have understood. Free mind, format, node color. Node color is to change the color of the font. Now over, almost all the color we have applied. Now next, how to give the entire node color, background color, not the font. Then go to the format. See, now right now it is empty. Then click this format, node background color. Now let me apply this color. Come out of it. Only then you can notice the change in color. Now education technology node changes with this color. Now assessment tool. Now go to the format, bubble, apply bubble. See, before applying bubble, look at everything is in the form of fork. This representation is named as fork. It's just opened. There is no other option for closing the box. Now to convert it into the box form, format bubble. Now look at Google form in, available in the form of bubble. See, notice it, control plus plus. Now it's available in the form of bubble. How to do this bubble? For example, rubric design, it's fork design. Now let us apply this bubble for box form. Now it is in the form of box. Assessment tool, bubble. Ruby Star, bubble. This all became bubble. Now Google Classroom, if the root we apply bubble, the entire child node will become bubble. Otherwise, if you apply only to the child node bubble, only that particular node will get the effect of bubble. If the entire stem, if you want to apply, just apply to the root, automatically the entire cluster will become bubbled. Now Edpuzzle. Now Edpuzzle, let us fill up. Edpuzzle, new child node. It has the feature for crop the video and double enter. And it has the feature for audio track, double enter. It has the feature for audio notes, double enter. It has the feature for quizzes. Now over. Now this Edpuzzle alone, let it be in the fork type so that you can notice what is bubble and what is fork type. Now this is over. To increase the entire mind map view, increase up to 150. Now you could clearly see the options of everything. Now so far now we have discussed about how to include background color, font color, how to use this bubble type, and by default it will be in the form of fork type. If you want to change it into box type, then you have to use this bubble. So far now we are using maximum format. Initially the navigate we used move to root, wherever this root node is available, to bring it to the middle of the page we have to apply this move root. That's all. Most of the time we will be using this format only, within the format, or we will be using right click. Right click, only these three we were discussing. Now let us see one more. Rubrics design, format, node background color, apply the background color mild green. See, now color is applied. Ruby Star format, apply node background color very mild color, pink color. Now Ruby Star is filled with pink and pink. Otherwise, let us change format, node background color, let it be violet. Now, Google Classroom, let us fill up with format, node background color. Let us fill up with one mild color so that the combination of front end, front font on background should be more visible and more attractive. Now color option is over. Now let us include icons. Right click, icons. Suppose in your discussion, the priority you want to set, then you can set the priority. Priority one, icons. Priority one. Then Google Classroom is the topic we are going to discuss. Icons, priority two. Then assessment tool or rubric design, icons, priority three. Then free mind, icons, priority four. Assessment tool, icons, priority five. Or you can use any other symbols also relevant to the context wherever you want to include, say oral presentation, you can include some icons. At this edge, you want to give this icon, oral presentation, mini project. This end you want to give, say team project or team presentation, you can give this. Scientific writing, there is no other option. Writing pen is there. Scientific writing, scientific drawing, again you can use the same pen. So you look at the available options of the icons, then you can include whichever the icon you would like to include. From this left end also you can include, or use the right click and go for icons and more explore and more this one. This is excellent tool. Edpuzzle allows the excellent crop option. So include icons. It allows to set the quizzes. So now let us include icons. It allows to set the question. And audio notes allowed to include our own ideas. So these are all the relevant symbols or icons I can include. Now, Google Classroom, we want to include some picture. So we are going to create new sibling above the, to remove the node, edit, remove. I don't want this node. So that I am removing. So let us include child node, new child node. Now it is here. Now how to include images, Google Classroom icon, how to include from the desktop. So let us create a node, then let us save the file, save. Already it is not at save. To include image, it is mandatory to save. Educationtechnologies.mm. MM is mind map. It is the extension. If you retain this extension, we can reuse this mind map for further enhancement, drawing or modifying, deleting some notes, including some notes, applying font color, etc. Anything this mind map you would like to expand in future, edit the same mind map in future, save it in the form of double MM, save. If you finally, once it is ready, if you want to download in the form of images, export in the form of PNG, JPEG, PDF, these are all the format it allow us to download. These are all advanced features as HTML, JavaScript version, Java Applet, Flash, etc. So for academic purposes, we can use PNG, JPEG and PDF. Let us see at the end of the drawing how to export this file as image. Once if you download in the form of image file, PNG or JPEG or PDF, you are not allowed to do any changes with this mind map. Nothing you can do. Just whatever is exported, you have to use it for the academic purposes. Anything you want to edit it, we have to safeguard with MM file. Now let us see how to import image. Click the node, insert, image file. In the desktop, already Google Classroom icon I have downloaded. Now I am importing the image. Now this image is ready. Now let me include image for Edpuzzle. So Edpuzzle, new child node, go to the insert option, image file option, Edpuzzle, icon for Edpuzzle included. Next, let us include the icon for Plickr. Create a new child node, then go to the insert option, image file, within that Plickers. Now this is the icon for Plickr. Create a new child node, Mentimeter, insert, image file, go to Menti icon. Now Kahoot, insert, new child, and again insert, image file, Kahoot. Now these are all the way you can include images into this existing mind map. Now Google Classroom is one of the image, Edpuzzle is one of the image, Plickr is one of the image, Mentimeter is one of the image, and the Kahoot is one of the image. These are all the way we can include images. Now image inclusion is also over. Next, let us look into the other features. These four features, we want to connect it together. Let us see. Crop, select the node, press the control simultaneously, click this, crop, quizzes. These two you want to connect. There is no logic in it, but anyway, here let us see, text effect and text cloud. So this text cloud is one of the special feature of text effect, so that I want to connect these two together. So first see, wherever you are in the mind map, click this option and press the control button, click the another option, go to insert, add graphical link. See, these two are linked together. If you want to change the shape and position, you are allowed to do. Next, for example, I want to connect all these three things together. Scientific presentation, team presentation, oral presentation. These three I want to connect together. So for example, oral presentation, team presentation, scientific presentation, insert, graphical link. Now these three are linked together. All are treated as one of the group. So next you are permitted to use, change the positions. So here, unknowingly here, few nodes are selected. So press Ctrl Z to undo, because we don't want connect this all, undo, undo. So only these two links enough. Now come out of this, click the first option, scientific presentation, team presentation, oral presentation. See to that no other node is highlighted or selected during the control button usage. Then once the desired number of nodes which you want to connect, interlink together, select all those nodes and go to insert, use, add graphical link. Now these two, scientific presentation, team presentation, both are related to oral presentation. Just we want to connect, these two are related to this, or these three are interlinked together. So this is the way we can use graphical link. So this graphical link is over. Next, how to include table? Let us look into table inclusion. Education technology, new child node. So here new node is opened. This is for table or table of list of educational activities. Now this is ready. Now within this we have to include tables. How to include? Let us look at. Now double click. Before including the table, we may have to include some picture. Only then it allows to edit this option table. So now you can delete this picture. Then you can use table number of columns 3. So the first one is, or you can remove serial number, name of the pedagogical activity. Next column is name of the technology. So now you want to include the next. Press tab to create a new row. Serial number. Now the first number is 1. Pedagogical activity is content preparation and administering learning activities. The name of the software is Google Classroom. If you want to include next row, press tab. Then serial number 2, then learning activity is for presentation. And writing. We can use FreeMind for presentation and writing. Okay. Now that image is deleted, the name of the table or content of the table is included. First, we may have to include the image. Then we may have to go to the double click mode. Then automatically it will be in the edit mode. Then we can delete the image. Then we can fill up the table. For example, let us include table for assessment tools. Here, assessment tool, new child node, it is here. Let me include one of the image first. For example, Google Classroom, just I'm, for the namesake, I'm including some image. Double click. Now you will be in this edit long node. Then delete this node, backspace or delete, table. 3 columns. Yes, serial number. Next, name of the assessment tool. Limitations. Next, press tab for the number 1 tool. Mentimeter. The limitation is for the open source, it allows to set only 7 slides or 7 quizzes. The next slide. 2. Kahoot. The limitation is it allows only 100 users to take part. 3. Plickers. There is no gamification. These are all the limitations. Okay. Now this table is included here. So this table explains about these 3 tools and its limitations. So this is the way we can include table options and images, graphical link. Now let us see one more interesting feature. Now we want to apply cloud, grouping all these together. Free, select this entire cluster, FreeMind, text effect, tables, graphics, text cloud. Go to format option. Okay, come here, it will be there here, cloud. Apply this blue color icon, cloud. Now this all clouded together, it will be distinguished among other options. So the highlight or the cluster of item under a common theme will be here. So now let us group these all together. Ruby star, select, scientific drawing, these all I want to apply cloud. Select all the nodes, whichever you want to do cloud or cluster together. Apply this blue color icon. Now, depending upon the tree shape, it will adjust automatically. Now this is one cloud, this is one cloud. There are two clouds we discussed, one cloud for FreeMind, one cloud for RubyStar. Next, let us apply cloud for only for these options. So select whatever the node you want, then apply cloud. Now these are all separately shown in the cloud form. So by experiencing, you will come to know. So for now, we discussed how to remove node, how to include images, how to include text effects, and next one more attractive feature, format, blinking node. So now it will start blinking. This blinking or color change option available only with the MM file. Only with this MM file. If you store this original version file, then if you start teaching with this mind map, only then this blinking option will be available. Otherwise, it is not possible. So if you want to export as an image file, then by the time when you are exporting this mind map, whatever the color is displayed in this blink, that will start recording. I will show you little later. Now, if you want to include hyperlink for the local file, for example, new child node, it is created here. Now, insert hyperlink file chooser. So in the desktop, about mind map, already the PPT is available. I want to include that PPT. During my presentation, I can just double click or I can include the text also. So this PPT will start opening. Then you can start your presentation demonstration. So this is the advantage of including hyperlink. The next other features, so let us discuss. Crop. Then go to tool. Again, go to format. Now you can change edge color, edge style, edge width. Now edge, for example, this is the edge. Very simple thin line it is available. Now Google Classroom, let us choose format, edge color. You can apply any one of the edge color, red color. So now this entire thing, instead of this gray color, it became red color. Let us see for edge puzzle, format, edge color, green color. We are going to apply green color. Now this entire edge became green. This entire cluster became pink. Now FreeMind. Now format, edge color, you can apply blue. Blue color it became. Now rubric design. Format, edge color, apply sky blue. Next, select this format. Go to the edge style. Bezier is there, sharp linear, sharp bezier. So now it is there. Now, one more option. Select the central node or this root node. Assessment tool, format, apply automatic layout. Now the short thickened line will come. Let me apply control Z. You will come to notice. See, very thin line. The edges are with a thin line. If you want to make it as a thick line, format, automatic layout. So it became very thick and sharp. So these are all the options. Next, few more important option, let us discuss over remove node background, reset position. So use rich formatting, change format. This all you can use it for changing the formats. Yes, now it's ready. Edit node, any node if you want to use, edit node, remove node, edit attributes. You can use this all for doing any more changes. Now let us save this file. Export. I'm exporting in the form of JPEG. Now desktop JPEG is ready. Now new share, desktop, share screen. See, look at this education technology. This image is available. Let us open this with picture manager. Okay. Now this is available in the form of picture. Once if it is exported in the form of picture, we can't edit, we can't do anything, we can't change the name of the node, nothing we could do. So always try using mm file. If we save mm file, after a couple of days also we can open this with a FreeMind software, then we can start editing or we can start decorating with the text effects. We can remove some nodes or we can include some node. With this we can move on with modification. Thanks for watching. Keep watching for further tools and demonstrations.